What's up, you skaters? It's Neil with Big Kids, and on this channel, we talk about DIY tips, vendors, and the electric skateboard community. If you're new here, please consider subscribing to see more videos just like this one. And don't forget to check the show notes below for any links or notes I leave in the description. In this video, we're gonna be doing a tutorial on how to build a DIY electric skateboard. This is gonna be part one of a two-part series. In this video, I'm gonna be building the longboard deck and the drivetrain. Also, I'm gonna be doing a raffle giveaway for this 1/5 scale hoverboard from the movie Back to the Future. To win this, click the link below for more details. But let's go get the parts and get building. So one thing I love doing is putting together an electric skateboard. And my buddy John had asked me to put one together for him on a budget. So we're gonna try doing that today, and I'm heading over to his house to go get those parts. Let's see what he has.
What's up?
What's up, bro? That was fast.
How you doing?
So you got the parts?
I got it, man.
Yeah, cool. So this is John.
Hey, what's up?
Can you tell the people why you want a DIY board?
Oh, it's like, I've always thought about getting one. It's just like really fun. But I did like a lot of research and I looked up, you know, all the different boards like Boosted and all those, and it was just like hella expensive. So saw this dude riding around the neighborhood one day and asked him, hey man, tell me about the board. And it was right in the price range. So I was like, can we build one? And he was like, let's do it.
Looks like you got all the parts. Check it out. Oh yeah. All right, bro. I'll check you later.
Good. All right, brother.
So let's start out by putting together the deck and the trucks. I have a 41 inch deck here, and the reason I chose this is because it's really long.
That's what she said.
My friend that's gonna be using this just kinda likes to cruise, and the longer deck that you have with a longer wheelbase. The wheelbase is the space between the two trucks. So the longer the spaces between the two trucks, the more stability you'll have. And then also to consider the type of deck material. This is a maple deck, so it's gonna be easier to handle at higher speeds. If you want something that will kind of muffle a little bit of the vibration from the ground, you might want to consider something softer like bamboo. What I ended up doing is getting these riser pads that are made out of rubber to kind of just absorb a little bit of that vibration. So this is what I ended up getting. I ended up getting caliber 2 trucks. You could get any trucks that you want, but these minimize the amount of customization that you need to do because a lot of the motor mounts that are out fit these type of trucks. They're 10 inches wide, which will make space for some big wheels. And also they have this flat spot, if you actually look right here, which actually helps when you put the motor mount on. So if you see, the motor mount also has a flat spot, and will help out with any movement. Put the riser pad on first, and then make sure that the truck is pointing out. This is called the KINGPIN, and you want, these are reverse KINGPIN trucks. You want these to be pointing out. So what I did is I made sure that the hardware was on first. It just looks like 4 screws that you're gonna wanna put through the top of the deck. And then make sure that the riser pad is on. That way it makes it a lot bit easier to put your truck on. screw on each nut. Make sure those are nice and snug. Now it's time to put on the bearings and the wheels onto your trucks. Did want to talk real quickly about the type of wheel that you want to choose. There are a couple different styles out there. One is being the flywheel clone, which is very popular. And then also is the orangutan kegels. Both of those types of wheels are supported by a lot of the e-skate vendors, and they do make wheel pulleys that are a nice fit for these type of wheels. Right in the middle is a hub, actually fits real nicely with the wheel pulley. So that's why for this build, I just recommend flywheel clones. The flywheel clones also are huge, as you can see here.
It's huge!
A big advantage to this is a higher top speed. You have a nice potential for top speed. And at the same time, when you're going over rough patches, you'll just kind of run over small gravel and things like that without any hesitation. Something that I do recommend before choosing your wheel is going to an e-skate calculator. There are a bunch of them online. I'll leave a link below where you can plug in your voltage, your wheel pulley ratio, and your wheel size to get your hypothetical high speed. And that will give you an idea of the parts that you wanna buy. These are your bearings, and then they come with two of them. And then they also come with what's called a spacer. The best way I find to put these onto your wheel is to put your bearing onto the truck and then pop that wheel right onto your truck. And then once you kind of hear a click, then you know it's in place. Next, you're gonna wanna put your other side of the bearing on, and then put your spacer on. It's a lot easier that way. Pop that in again. If it doesn't pop in correctly, just use your thumbs and there you go. So here we have all the parts for the wheel pulley and the wheel. You're gonna get 6 bolts, the 36 tooth pulley, and this plate for the outside of the wheel. And then you have the wheel. If you look here, the wheel actually has these little gaps, and then it also has these posts. The post, you're gonna wanna align between this little space between the two holes. These holes are where you're gonna screw in the bolts, and then you're gonna want it to go in between each post.
That's what she said.
Ha. Like that. I do recommend that you find a drill bit that has possibly the same size as this so that you can make kind of like a pilot hole for this to kind of go through. You could see the gap. I'm gonna drill very close to the post because that's where the bolts are gonna go. The bolts are now in place. I want to make sure that they're straight as possible, and I'm going to manually put these in just so that there are no mistakes putting them through. What you'll find is once they kind of come out the other side, you're going to want to take your wheel pulley and match it up to the holes that are coming through. I do find this part of the project to be pretty challenging because you could get it screwed in, but you wanna make sure that this wheel pulley is as flush and balanced as possible to the wheel because you don't want like a lopsided pulley kinda turning like this. You want it to really turn nice and even the whole way through. So this is the motor. It's a 6374 motor at 190 kV. KV is RPMs per volt, so the rotations per volt supplied is 190 revolutions. The higher the KV, the higher top speed that you're gonna have, but then you sacrifice torque. And then the lower the KV, the more torque you're gonna have, but then the more you sacrifice on the speed. This is a 6374 motor. So what that's talking about is the size of the motor. It's 63 millimeters in diameter and 74 millimeters in length. It's a big, big motor. Definitely something that will get you up hills with no problem. If you do have some concerns about going up hills and not ruining your motor, you can always do a dual motor setup, which won't necessarily make you go faster, but it's gonna help you get up those hills more efficiently. So this is the motor mount. Here's what you get. This is the D-clamp, which attaches directly to the truck. This is the motor plate, which attaches to the motor with these metric screws. So the reason I like this mount is because it's all aluminum, which makes it an effective heat sink for the motor. Every motor is a bit different, so let's start by putting the motor to the motor plate. So what I'm doing here is a preliminary dry fit of the bolts. The reason that you want to do that is so that you can make sure the belts have the right clearance and the right tension. After that, you're going to want to go and add some thread locker to the bolts that are connected to the motor and the pulley, because the thread locker is super key to making sure the bolts don't loosen with the vibration of the motor. So let's go ahead and just kind of loosely put these bolts on so that we could get an idea. This right here is the 16 tooth motor pulley. It attaches to the shaft of the motor, and what keeps this in place and not spin on its own is this little metal piece that fits into the keyway. So you're gonna wanna put that in there. If you see right here, that should fit directly onto here. So I have the little metal piece in the keyway. And then let's slip this motor pulley on, and it's done. And what you're gonna wanna do is make sure to tighten these as tight as you can. Also add some thread locker after you've done your dry fit. All motor mounts are different, but have kind of the same concept. With this specific motor mount, I'm gonna put the D-clamp on and tighten it pretty tight. And then I'll add the motor plate onto the D-clamp right after I tighten everything. The reason I do that is because if you fasten the motor mount to the D-clamp first and then put the D-clamp on, it won't fully tighten. So, you know, E-Skate is not a perfect system, like I've mentioned, and there are little quirks to different pieces, and that's kind of the quirk about this motor mount. After tinkering around for a little bit and making sure my belt tension was right and everything was in place, I'm gonna start adding some thread locker. This is the thread blocker blue, and I'm gonna be what I end up doing. It, to be honest with you, thread locker is kind of like a glue slash like hardener that you add to the threads. Just a little bit goes a long way. I'd add it to kind of just the bottom part. You don't need that much because it really sticks. And then go ahead and screw that in the way you want. One of my DIY electric skateboard series was helpful to you guys. Together we built the longboard, the motor, and the pulleys. In my next video, we'll be putting together the electronics and the electronic speed control. If you guys built your electric skateboard already, what was most challenging to you guys? Leave a comment below for other e-skate builders to check out, and learn from the e-skate community, you guys. And don't forget to share and smash that like button if you like this video. Thanks again, and see you in the next one. Peace! Yo, what's up, e-skaters? Neil with Big Kids. Are you looking to... What's up, e-skaters? Neil with Big Kids. Are you looking to build an electric... 1/5 scale hoverboard from the...